Who is the greatest short story writer? The modern short story, printed for commercial purposes and read for edification and or entertainment, has really only been going since the 18th century. The Russian author Anton Chekhov is usually considered to be the category's master, though some people prefer the Frenchman Guy de Maupassant. Arguably, Catherine Mansfield is better than both. She became so by deploying some of the tools of modernism, thus outreaching our forebears. In any case, I do think that Lorrie Moore may be the short story's greatest living practitioner. Moore was born in New York State in 1957, and she's an academic by profession. In 2020, Everyman collaborated with her to publish 40 of her short stories spanning her entire career. Interestingly, she chose to present the collection in alphabetical order of their titles, on the grounds that attempting to glimpse the growth of an author through chronological arrangement is often a fool's errand. What distinguishes her stories is above all the quality of the writing. You really have to read them to appreciate that. In many ways, she's from the Chekhovian slice of life school rather than the beginning, middle, end one, but there's a definite sense of progression in all of her stories. Many feature individuals who are interesting in their own right. By that, I mean they would stand out if you were to meet them, and they're given complex voices that respect that. Across the 40 stories, in one way or another, the whole of human life appears, including the tragic. People like that are the only people here is about the serious illness of a child and is loosely based on the author's own experience. The other side of the coin is her humour. In general, I don't think it's always appreciated how close funny ha-ha and really good writing are to each other. The connection lies in the shock of the unexpected. You catch your breath and release the tension in a laugh. So, for example, Dance in America, the seventh story in this collection, begins with what sounds like a sombre technical exposition, before the narrator admits he's made it all up. And the writing is concentrated. Take the first paragraph of Childcare, the fifth story in here, and it's almost a story in itself. To return to the question at the beginning, who is the greatest short story writer? I don't know, but if you want to find out, you could do a lot worse than start here.